Nathan Detroit. One of the great comedy roles I've ever written.
Who is Adelaide? Miss Adelaide sings at the Hot Box nightly, a very respectable joint.
Miss Sarah Brown, her father was a gambler, so she's rebelled against that and she's gone very straight.
So I don't know who Sky is. He's a gambler. He likes the long shot.
We want to just do a few sections because there are places where we're locking instrumental groups together on tracks, and we want to make sure we get the balance right.
Trumpets.
So could we hear a section with all the trumpets, just the trumpets?
You do have a sense of wanting to do it right, wanting to do it a little bit different, and you often get a momentum that's very, very good. There's a camaraderie that takes place in the studio, and it's wonderful, and you really sometimes get marvelous results by knocking yourself out for, 12 or 14 hour stretch.
Let's do a take. Stand by, please.
I love dancing with the music, and I love when the rhythm is right and the trumpets are just in a certain groove. It affects me in a very good way, and I actually believe that it goes through me and back to them, and they see it and sort of catch it too, and that's why it sounds so good. But I have to say, it isn't anything I'm manufacturing. I really, they're good, and the music is great, and the thrill of doing a classic Broadway show with a score like this just adds to the joy.
I got the horse right here, the name is Paul Revere, and here's the guy that says if the weather's clear, can do, this guy says the horse can do, if he says the horse can do, can do.
I'm making Valentine, cause on the morning line, the guy has got him figured at 5 to 9. But look at Epitaph, he waited by a half, according to this here is a telegraph.
For Paul Revere out bite, I hear his foot's all right. Of course it all depends if it rained last night.
I know it's Valentine, the morning marks look fine. Besides the jockey's brother's a friend of mine. And just a minute, boys, I got the feed mark's noise. It says his great-grandfather was equipoise.
Your Paul Revere, now this is no bum steer. It's from a handicap, and that's real sincere.
I hope for Valentine, cause on the morning line, the guy has got him figured at 5 to 9.
make it happy, 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 happy,
happy, happy, happy, happy,
I got the horse right here.
Okay, Eddie, let's do one more. Yep. Stand by, please.
Hook it up. Here we go.
Think, think, think.
All right, bar six.
Right here.
It's a transition because people are hearing it, they're not seeing it. So there's certain things you have to take out and certain things you have to put in. But it's just how much they want of the little added frills that we do every night and what doesn't make sense because you're not seeing it.
He needs me. In other words, just from waiting around for that plain little band of gold.
A person can develop a cold. You can spray her wherever you figure the streptococci lurk. You can give her a shot for whatever she's got, but it just won't work. If she's tired of getting the fisheye from the hotel clerk, a person can develop a cold.
Just be careful with the pitch of the first note. It was a little flat this time.
It was great. I have nothing to tell you, except I want to give her a chance to do one more. She have a little more fun with things a little bit, just so we have one in case we want to edit. It sounded great. If we had to use this one, we would. Let's do it, okay? Let's do it again. Good.
I'm just concerned that afterwards we won't discover that it's a little bland or blander than it could be, that's all. I don't want it to become shtick and hokey and all of that, but I just want to make sure that we don't find out later that, you know, she could have done a little more of this and a little more of that, you know?
I think she's going to try to recreate exactly what she needs in the performance. I'll just mention it to her, okay? Go ahead. Yeah, yeah, good.
I think this is really just about protecting them a little bit, making sure as much as I can that the essence of what works for them on stage gets translated into the recording. That they feel safe. You know, it's sort of just an extension of the work we've been doing, but it's in a different context with a lot of people watching, a lot of strangers watching, a lot of new authority figures, the people behind the board. I mean, there's just a lot of different pressures. So as easygoing as they may want to appear, you know, cups of coffee in their hands, sort of a jaunty little jokes to people walking in the room, there's a certain amount of terror.
It says here, the average unmarried female, basically insecure, due to some long frustration, may react with psychosomatic symptoms difficult to endure, affecting the upper respiratory tract. In other words, just from waiting around for that plain little band of gold, a person can develop a cold. You can spray her wherever you figure the streptococci lurk. You can give her a shot for whatever she's got, but it just won't work. If she's tired of getting the fisheye from the hotel clerk, a person can develop a cold. It says here, the female remaining single, just in the legal sense, shows a neurotic tendency. See note. Tendency. See note. Oh, see note. Oh, I don't like that. Chronic organic syndromes, toxic or hypertense, involving the eye, the ear, the nose, and throat. In other words, just from worrying whether the wedding is on or off, a person can develop a cough. You can spray her wherever you... Shit, I missed the line. Sorry, it was me.
That's so good.
Adelaide,
doesn't say shit. Faith does. Sorry. It's hard without my book here, Jerry.
Let's go back to the end of C note, that thing.
This is 59.
Okay. Bar 35.
And what am I actually starting singing, Eddie?
What's a pitch of G flat? Tendency.
Thank you, Larry.
Here we go. Ready?
Tendency, C note.
Tendency, Jerry gives you so many new ideas and fresh ways of looking at it. And he gave me a lot of things that I don't think I would have seen. I mean, she is in a predicament, but he sort of gave me a positive way of going at it. And he said things like, at all possible cost, she would not ruin this relationship with Nathan.
Just from worrying whether the wedding is on or off, a person can develop a cough. You can feed her all day with the vitamin A and the bromophens, but the medicine never gets anywhere near where the trouble is. If she's getting a kind of a name for herself and the name ain't his, a person can develop a cough. And furthermore, just from stalling and stalling and stalling the wedding trip, a person can develop lock rip. When they get on the train for Niagara and she can hear church bells chime, the compartment is air conditioned and the mood sublime. Then they get off at Saratoga for the 14th time. A person can develop lug rip, la post nasal drip with a wheezes and a sneezes and a sinus that's really a pip. From a lack of community property and a feeling she's getting too old, a person can develop a big, bad cough.
I think it's great. Just leave it alone.
Yeah, yeah.
Sensational, Faith.
We're doing this for posterity. And little children all over America will be listening to me and want to go into show business because of me and ruin their lives. All because of me and this
call
show.
About them.
It's a wonderful show. You know, it's a classic. You know, it's an American. It's the quintessential American musical comedy. Otherwise, I wouldn't have done it. I wouldn't have done, you know, Oklahoma. I did the quintessential American. And that's why we're a blockbuster. It's bigger than Cats. Now and forget about it.
Okay, stand by, please.
I feel like Ed McMahon.
Usually that song is done as sort of a throwaway number for Nathan and Adelaide. And Jerry and Nathan and I kind of found a whole scene within the three verses that go on in Sumi. And Jerry sort of gave us certain inflections. And I sing the same end of the verse three times. When I think of the time gone by and I think of the way I try, I could honestly die. And usually it's played all the same. And I've tried to find three different responses with the same lyric.
And you can do a little bit more.
Okay.
I can honestly die.
Just I could honestly die.
Just slightly melodramatic.
Okay.
You think. You know, don't be afraid. And don't be afraid to, you can push it a little bit in your voice. I can honestly do. You know, don't worry, it won't be too much.
All right.
And since we can't see you, it really needs that. Okay. But
Jerry talks about it like passing the ball. He always says, make sure you're passing the ball. And he loves when you're passing the ball. And we do a lot of that. And but between he and Nathan and I, mean, it's been a great trio. It's funny, Nathan and I don't really socialize much. We don't go out a lot together. Yeah, you know, but once we hit the theater, it's like the boundaries of what we are. We're very tender with each other. We're very loving. We don't talk about the work a lot. We just do it.
I'm very happy when people tell me that there's a real sort of magical chemistry with the two of us, because and that they believe that this has been a long-term 14-year relationship, and that they're very adult and sort of it's sort of sexy and funny and so and how deeply the two Nathan and Adelaide care about each other.
Nathan, why can't we elope right now?
Because, well, I gotta go to a prayer meeting.
Nathan, this is the biggest lie you ever told me!
But I promise you it's true!
You promise me this, you promise me that, you promise me anything under the sun, then you give me a kiss and you're grabbing your hat and you're off to the races again. When I think of the time gone by,
Adelaide, Adelaide.
And I think of the way I
tried,
I could honestly die.
Call a lawyer and sue me, what can you do me? I love you. Give a holler and hate me, go ahead, hate me.
The I best love years you. Of my life, I was a fool to give to
all
you.
Right already, I'm just a no good Nick. All right already, it's true. So new? So sue me, what can you do me? I love you.
You gamble it here, you gamble it there, you gamble on everything all except me, and I'm sick of you keeping me up in the air. You're back in the money again when I think of the time gone by.
Adelaide, Adelaide.
And I look at the way I...
Adelaide!
I could honestly die.
Serve a paper and sue me, what can you do me? I love you. Give a holler and hate me, go ahead, hate me,
when
I love you.
When you wind up in jail, don't come to me to bail you.
Right. Already, so call a policeman. All right, already, it's true. So new, so sue me, what can you do me? I love you.
You're at it again, you're running the game. I'm not gonna play second fiddle to that. And I'm sick and I'm tired of strolling around. I'm telling you now that we're through. When I think of the time gone by,
Adelaide, Adelaide.
And I think of the way I tried,
Adelaide.
I could honestly die.
Sue me, shoot bullets through me. I love you.
That's terrific. Everybody's happy in here. Jerry's happy, I'm happy. And I think we should take a 10-minute.
That was great. It was absolutely great.
Yes.
That was perfect. Let's move on.
All
yeah.
Right.
Oh, it was wonderful.
Great
adjustments. Very nice. You sound wonderful. Absolutely wonderful.
He was nervous.
Of course. The terrible.
His little
wreck.
Hands are cold. He's never been
See,
like
usually
this.
I'm sure. Usually this would have been done on the floor, but I figured you'd feel a lot more comfortable up on a stage with everyone looking at you.
Like no.
What key is this in? In.
This is all in. This is in 4 flats.
No, I'm sure the D-flat is right. I know, Frank, that's a Frank Lesser thing. A G7 chord with a flat 5. Should we just play this bar slowly?
Yeah.
All right, in 4-4 time, measure 109. Just play da 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 da. Measure 109. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4. I know it's right.
Let's just make sure everyone else in the bass registers on the third beat of 109 has a concert D flat.
That's Michael Starobin, and he's the one who's coordinating all the orchestration. So he goes out there, particularly when you make a change. If you make a cut, for example, and you take 20 bars out or 40 bars or whatever, a lot of these players double. For example, the wind players, you might have a player who plays 4 or 5 different instruments. And the orchestrations in this case could be very cleverly written so that the guy has time to play, let's say he's playing on a clarinet, he has 4 measures to put down the clarinet and pick up a saxophone.
Wait,
Now, if you cut those four measures out for musical reasons and you're not aware that that cut may cause you a big problem, you may suddenly have lost that pause where the player has a chance to put down an instrument and pick up another one. And sometimes also for a recording, you'll find that some orchestration is a little overwritten and you want to thin it out a little bit, reinforcing melodies in the vocal lines, that sort of thing. And a good orchestrator like Starobin is just sensational, that sort of thing. They know exactly what to do.
So why don't we get this one a little closer? It doesn't feel like it's 5 miles away.
All right. And we'll look down on those two. The rest of them.
Yeah, so you'll hear bada bada, Nathan concentrate on the game. Actually, hang on one second. Kim, make it Nathan concentrate on the crap game.
Okay.
And then as written, as you do it, you know, the town's up to here, et cetera, et cetera.
Nathan, concentrate on the crap game. The town is up to here with high players, the Greeks in town.
Brandy Bottle Bates.
Scranton Slim.
I know I could make a fortune, but where can I have the game? The Biltmore Garage wants a grand.
But we ain't got a grand on hand.
And they've now got a lock on the door of the gym at PS 84. There's the stock room behind McCluskey's bar.
But Mrs. McCluskey ain't a good scout.
And things being how they are, the back of the police station is out. So the Biltmore Garage is the spot.
But the 1,000 bucks we ain't got. Why is good old reliable Nathan Detroit? If you're looking for action, you'll furnish the spot. In quiet and peace, in a hideout provided by Nathan, where there are no neighbors to squawk. It's the oldest established permanent floating in New York. Where's the action? Where's the game?
Gotta have the game or we'll die from shame.
It's the oldest established.
Terrific. Thanks very much. And before we do personal impact, what I'd like to do, if it's okay, is take a 10-minute break early.
It's not such a good house we have out there tonight.
I started out doing musicals, and I haven't sung on Broadway in 10 years, so I feel this tremendous kind of feeling of privilege to be doing this show and these songs and these dances and these scenes and sort of be old enough to appreciate it, you know. And young enough to be able to do it.
He loves me. He loves me not. He loves me. He loves me not. He loves me. And I love you. A bushel and a peck. You bet your pretty neck I do. Diddle, diddle, diddle. Goodbye now.
Well, but we can't do.
Through these rim shots, I come in on doodle-doodle-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And when they're doing something to them, it's okay, but it's something that's overlaid what's going on musically, that if I don't see a movement with it, I hear just a drummer going doing rim shots for no reason.
If you insist, everything adds character, so... No, everything is part of the all of stuff.
Except the except all the rim shots in a row. They sound really out of place without saying something.
I don't agree.
They sound like he's in the wrong place if you don't see the kicks that go with it.
I don't agree. If other people agree with you, it's fine.
I'm not even sure. The question now we're discussing is restoring some of the melody at the end, even though the parts are blocked out.
I think we're fine.
The original cast album doesn't have any of the dance music on it at all. In fact, when I was looking for it, I had to listen to the movie soundtrack, the movie laser, not even the movie recording. The video of the movie. So this is great that we're getting all this music down. Plus, there's a lot of new music that's been created for the dancing that I'm very proud that it's going to be recorded. I really am.
Okay. Yeah. Hello. That's right. You know, not angry. Sneer your lip at me. But, you know. Hello. It's enthusiastic, but don't make it cute. All right.
Good. Okay. Yeah.
So they could do all the chick chick and those.
I think so. All your chick chicks. All your chick chick.
Oh, chick chick.
Right.
Oh my God.
Right.
Sure. You know, there's a part where they stamp their feet behind me before I start singing.
No.
We're not going to get that.
No.
So he'll just bring me in.
Right.
Okay.
Have a good time.
And now, for the grand finale of Around the World Review, we take you down on the farm with our star, Miss Adelaide, and the Hot Box Chick Chick Chickie!
Try to do is tell exactly the same story we're telling 8 times a week, but just do it strictly, you know, with my voice. But I don't know. I mean, I really hope I can pull it off. I just heard these guys in there singing Oldest Established, and it was really, really thrilling. I mean, if anybody wants to have, if I've ever had any, you know, fantasies of being Frank Sinatra, and this is my day.
A little give and take, guys. All right, come on, you've seen me roll for.
Oh, in other words, that's great. That way, because that threw me up. Because that way, my response, when you see me roll for 100 G's, will be in response to
the
ad lib. Sort of.
That's exactly right. And again, come in with it before. So just talk. It'll sound something like this.
What? What? What are you talking about?
Let me do it.
Run,
oh,
yeah.
Listen.
Give me
the dice
and give me room.
All right.
Give me the dice
and give me room. Oh, yeah. You've seen me roll for 100 G's. But I got a little more than dough riding on this one. They call you Lady Luck, but there is room for doubt. At times you have a very unladylike way of running out. You're on this date with me, the pickings have been lush, and yet before this evening is over you might give me the brush. You might forget your manners, you might refuse to stay, and so the best that I can do is pray. Luck be a lady tonight. Luck be a lady tonight. Luck, if you've ever been a lady to begin with, luck be a lady tonight. Luck, let a gentleman see how nice a dame you can be. I know the way you've treated other guys you've been with. Luck be a lady with me. A lady doesn't leave her escort. It isn't fair, it isn't nice. A lady doesn't wander all over the room and blow on some other guy's dice. So let's keep the party polite. Never get out of my sight. Stick with me, baby, I'm the fellow you came in with. Luck be a lady. Luck be a lady. Luck be a lady tonight.
Luck be a lady tonight. Luck be a lady tonight. Luck, if you've ever been a lady to begin with, luck be a lady tonight.
Luck, let a gentleman see how nice a dame you can be.
How nice a dame you can be.
I know the way you've treated other guys you've been with.
Luck be a lady with me.
A lady wouldn't flirt with strangers. She'd have a heart, she'd have a soul. A lady wouldn't make little snake eyes at me when I bet my life on this roll. So let's keep the party polite. Never get out of my sight. Stick with me, baby, I'm the fellow you came in with. Luck be a lady.
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 Hi, Josie.
How are you?
Good.
How
are you doing, Phoebe? Of course, I'm a little nervous. More excited. I'm really excited because this is such beautiful music. I think after a couple of times, though, you just relax and you do the work. It's just a little bit of a different focus and concentration, so that your voice sounds good. You know, when you're performing, if you crack once or twice, you know, you're performing. You know, but in this, you don't want people to hear that. You know, whenever they put on the record.
Poker deck and
sounds great. We're going to do one more of the vocal from Follow the Fold, where we, after the, without the musical injury, just the singing part.
I think the part of Sarah is just wonderful. Okay. And I like Jerry's take on Sarah. Jerry saw her as a real healer, somebody who was good at what she did, but unfortunately was doing it in the wrong place. She's funny and she has this journey where she changes. It's not a total transformation, it's more like a breakthrough. It's somebody who's just waiting to come out but hasn't found the right way, the right venue, the right person to help that other side of her come out. At this point, Adelaide's Sarah's teacher. Sarah's learning from Adelaide. So they start this little coercion, you know, the two of them.
What are we, crazy or something? At Wanamaker's and Saks and Klein's, a lesson I've been taught. You can't get alterations on a dress you haven't bought. At any vegetable market from Borneo to Nome, you mustn't squeeze a melon till you get the melon home. You simply gotta gamble. You get no guarantee. Now doesn't that kind of apply to you and I? You and me.
Why not what?
Marry the man today. Trouble though he may be. Much as he likes to play. Crazy and wild and free. Marry the man today. Rather than sigh and sorrow. Marry the man today and change his ways tomorrow.
Marry the man today.
Marry the man today.
Let him get away.
Don't let him get away.
Hurry and track him down.
Have her attack him and marry the man today. Give him the girlish laughter.
Give him your hand today and save the fist for after.
Slowly introduce him to the better things. Respectable, conservative, and clean.
Reader's Digest.
Guy Lombardo.
Rogers Pete.
Ovaltine, but marry the man today. Handle it meek and gently. Marry the man today and train him
subsequently. Carefully expose him to domestic life. And if he ever tries to stray from you, have a pot roast.
Have a headache.
Have a baby.
Have two.
Six.
Nine.
Stop.
Marry the man today, rather than sigh and sorrow. Marry the man today and change his ways.
And change his ways.
And change his ways.
Change his ways.
Change his ways. Tomorrow.
Peter and I met 15 years ago, I think, or 14 years ago. We're good friends, and we always wanted to work together. And he went to L.A., and I hadn't seen him in years, but I remember when we were younger and we were saying we'd like to work together someday. And then all of a sudden, here we are doing Sky and Sarah, where we're lovers, and it's so wonderful.
We've known each other for almost 15 years, and we did not our first show. I was my second. I was doing Grease on Broadway on 45th Street, and she was next door doing Runaways, Liz Suedo's musical, and I used to... used to hang out, the Greases used to hang out on the sidewalk and check out all the girls in Runaways. And she got a lot of checking out. And so it was, you know, and it's been a happy, a joyful kind of reuniting.
Sorry, guys. Can I just do a little melody part, just for the... My time of day is the dark time. My time of day is the dark time. Of day is the dark time.
like My Time of Day, I think is, you know, one of the most evocative songs about New York at 4 a.m. and that kind of peace and solitude that you can find in a bustling city that I've ever, I mean, it's poetic.
The solo was so good, and we wanted to hear what it sounded like without any lines over it. I think as soon as the saxophone solo starts, that's when you have to come in, Joyce.
I don't know. I was kind of lulled into a state of higher consciousness. Thank you, Red. The view is beautiful from up there.
Okay, this is take 124. 124.
Thank you for bringing me back. I must have behaved very badly.
No, you were fine.
What time is it?
I don't know, 4 o'clock.
This is your time of day, isn't it? I'm not usually up this late.
How do you like it?
It's so peaceful and wonderful.
You're finding out something I've known for quite a while. My time of day is the dark time. A couple of deals before dawn, when the street belongs to the cop and the janitor with the mop and the grocery clerks are all gone. When the smell of the rain-washed pavement comes up clean and fresh and cold, and the street lamp light fills the gutter with gold. That's my time of day. My time of day. And you're the only doll I've ever wanted to share it with me. Obadiah.
Obadiah, what's that?
Obadiah Masterson, that's my real name. You're the first person I ever told it to. I've never been in love before. Now all at once it's you. It's you forevermore. I've never been in love before. I thought my heart was safe. I thought I knew the score. But this is wine that's all too strange and strong. I'm full of foolish song, and out my song must roar. So please forgive this helpless haze I'm in. I've really never been in love before.
I've never been in love before. Now all at once it's you. It's you forevermore. I've never been in love before. I thought my heart was safe. I thought I knew the score. But this is wine that's all too strange and strong. I'm full of foolish song, and out my song must pour.
So please forgive this helpless haze I'm in. I've really never been in love before.
He just doesn't remember to take that breath.
That song? That's
my time, and she's he.
Oh. Yeah. Now, he forgets to take the breath before. That's he bridges into the strong. That's my time of day. Instead of we were just talking about it, and if he just.
The street lamp light fills the gutter with gold.
That's breath. My right, and that's what we want. We want the breath there. Well, because what happens is he runs out on the other end, and it's Streetland Light fills the gutter with gold. That's my time of day. No? Never? Then what's happening at the Streetland Light fills the gutter with gold. That's my time of day.
We don't have to just, don't hold gold quite so long, maybe. Move into the next frame.
He needs a breath before he does that. That's where he needs a breath. There's it. He needs a, does he take it after the light?
Oh, yes.
That's where he needs it.
My favorite song is My Time of Day, because I know that's so Frank. Because he got up every morning at 4 o'clock in the morning. He never slept past four, and he wrote until 8 in the morning. And he liked those hours, those early hours. And I think it's an art song. I think it's a true art song, as a Schubert song, I think it is. I think it's that simple, that beautiful, that good song. And I guess it reminds me a lot of Frank. I know the show very well. I've seen the show twice when Frank did it at City Opera, so I knew what he wanted, and I know how he wanted it to sound.
It is a Bible in its own right. You have to respect the fact that it's good. It's great, but you can't worship it in that way. You have to pretend that the composer handed it to you, laid it out on the piano and said, how do you like this? And we look at it, and because it's so good, we say, wow, that's great. But then we take it and we make it our own, and we fit it to the singer. It's very important, and I believe we succeeded in this, that everyone in the show is singing from their heart. Everyone is singing the dramatic, correct thing for the scene, the correct thing for the song. They're not just performing an old Frank Lesser song. It has become a part of them and a part of the scene and a part of the musical.
Are you happy with the head of My Time of Day? I feel like I haven't felt confident on coming in with My Time of Day is the dark time. Has it sounded right to you, or does it sound like somebody, a singer who's not quite sure?
I think it's been all right. If you're in doubt, let's do one beginning there.
Would you mind? I'd really feel better if we could.
This is take 129.
Here we go. I'll count you three. One, two.
My time of day is the dark time. A couple of deals before dawn, when the street belongs to the cop and the janitor with the mop.
I thought that was good.
It's better, wasn't it?
Oh, I think it is. So leave it to us to put it together. I think you're fine.
As long as you have fun.
Yeah, I think we're covered.
Let's do If I Were a Bell.
Let's do If I Were a Bell. Let's do it right away.
Yes, how do we begin?
He says, are you all right?
Are you all right?
Am I all right? Ask me how do I feel. Ask me now that we're cozy and clinging. Well, sir, all I can say is if I were a bell, I'd be ringing. From the moment we kissed tonight, that's the way I've just got to behave. Boy, if I were a lamp, I'd light. And if I were a banner, I'd wave. Ask me how do I feel, little me with my quiet upbringing. Well, sir, all I can say is if I were a gate, I'd be swinging. And if I were a watch, I'd start popping my I go ding dong, ding dong, ding. Ask me how do I feel from this chemistry lesson I'm learning.
chemistry.
Well, sir, all I can say is if I were a bridge, I'd be burning. Yes, I knew my morale would crack from the wonderful way that you looked. Boy, if I were a duck, I'd quack. Or if I were a goose, I'd be cooked. Ask me how do I feel. Ask me now that we're fondly caressing. Pal, if I were a salad, I know I'd be splashing my dressing. Ask me how to describe this whole beautiful thing. Well, if I were a bell, I'd go ding dong, ding dong, ding.
Josie, that was your best singing so far on this group, and I think we're finished with it, and I think Jerry agrees, and Michael.
Producers like Jay tried to capture the experience of the show on an album, which, you know, so that you get a sense of what it is. For a lot of people, it's their first way of discovering musical theater. I mean, especially now, people of my generation, first experience in musical theater was hearing cast albums. That's how I first got to know Sondheim scores and all the other scores. And that's a really different experience from getting to know them in the theater, which is sad, but that's how it starts.
Okay, this is going to be the first take of Sit Down, You're Rockin' the Boat, and it's take 84.
We will now hear testimony from Brother Nicely Nicely Johnson. Brother Nicely Nicely Johnson!
Well, it happened to me kind of funny, like a dream. That's it, a dream!
Well, tell us in your own words.
I dreamed last night I got on the boat to heaven, and by some chance I had brought my dice along. And there I stood, and I hollered, someone save me. But the passengers, they knew right from wrong. For the people said, sit down, you're rocking the boat.
People said, sit down, you're rocking the boat.
And the devil will drag you under by the sharp lapel of your checkered coat. Sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down.
Sit down, you're rocking the boat.
I sailed away on that little boat to heaven, and by some chance found a bottle in my fist. And there I stood, nicely passing out the whiskey, but the passengers were bound to resist. For the people all said, beware, you're on a heavy trip. People all said,
beware,
you'll scuttle the ship. And the devil will drag you under by the fancy tie around your wicked throat. Sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down,
sit down, sit down, sit down, you're back in the boat.
And as I laughed at those passengers to heaven, a great big wave came and washed me overboard. And as I sank and I hollered, someone save me, that's the moment I woke up, thank the Lord. And I said to myself, sit down,
sit down, you're rocking the boat.
Said to myself, sit down, you're rocking the boat. And the devil will drag you under with a soul so heavy you'd never float. Sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down,
sit down, you're rocking the boat. Sit down, you're rocking, rocking the boat.
At the Roxy, I'll tell you what's playing at the Roxy. A picture about a Minnesota man so in love with a Mississippi girl that he sacrifices everything and moves all the way to Biloxi. That's what's playing at the Roxy.
What's in the Daily News? I'll tell you what's in the Daily News. Story about a guy who bought his wife a small ruby with what otherwise would have been his union dues. That's what's in the Daily News.
What's happening all over? I'll tell you what's happening all over. Guy sitting home by a television set who once used to be something of a rover.
That's what's happening all over. Love is the thing that has licked him. And it looks like Nathan's just another victim.
Yes, sir.
Can you see a guy?